The number one reason why most businesses are not able to get results with their website is because number one, they're not hiring the right person, and number two, they don't have a checklist to make sure everything is done the correct way. Thankfully, I'm here, and in this video, I'm going to give you that complete checklist so that if you want to hire someone else to make your website, you'll make sure they do everything perfectly. This video is also great for web designers that want to do an awesome job for their client. Without wasting any more time, I'll transfer you over to my laptop and let's get into it. All right, guys, so I cooked you up a little presentation for the website design checklist for service businesses. So if you have a service business, you can click the first link in the description and open up this, send it over to your web designer so he can go through everything. Or if you're a web designer yourself, you can click the first link in the description and go through this whole checklist yourself. This checklist is going to outline the main key points for developing a successful website for your service business. We're going to be going through the core website elements, meaning having a professional domain, secure hosting, mobile responsive design, service descriptions, having clear detailed pages for each service, professional credibility, an about page, certifications. For example, if you want the Homestar's Best Construction Business 2024, it's great to have that on your website as well. Client engagement, so having contact forms. So if someone is interested in your services, he can just fill out a contact form that will go directly into your email inbox. Trust building, like client testimonials. Technical requirements, like fast loading speed, for example, and client resources such as frequently asked questions section. We're going to be going through all of this in detail, so make sure you listen carefully. Let's go to the next step. Alrighty, so the first thing the person who's building your website should ask you is, what is the purpose and what are your goals with that website? So number one, you want to make sure you clearly define the website's purpose and align with whatever business goals you have. For example, if your goal is to get more clients, in that case, the website will be a high converting website that's able to not only generate leads, but also convert those leads into clients, generating more revenue for your company, obviously increasing your profit, right? You want to make sure you consider both short-term objectives, like generating leads, and long-term vision, such as becoming an industry authority. The second thing you want to do is target audience, identifying your ideal customer and tailor the design and content to resonate with them. For example, I only work with service businesses, and the reason why I only work with service businesses is because I've worked with so many in the past. When I'm doing the copywriting or the design for the website, I know exactly which words to use as well as which terminologies, so whoever is visiting the website will resonate with it and they can convert at a higher rate, obviously generating more revenue for whatever client I have, right? So understanding your audience is crucial for creating an effective website strategy. All right, so on this next page, we have design and user experience. So the first thing we have on this page is branding consistency. For example, if you already have a website and your logo is blue, the person you hire to make your website, obviously you don't want to make the whole website red because red and blue are two complete different colors, right? Make sure you have consistent coloring, consistent fonts, and consistent style. If you have a luxurious logo, you don't want to change up the colors on your website, have three different colors, and make your website look childish because the brand you already established is a luxurious brand. Number two, we have mobile responsiveness. I can't even count how many websites I've seen that look good on desktop, but they don't even look good on mobile. That's extremely important because most people actually come from their phone. So make sure the website looks good on every single device, whether it's tablet, desktop, or mobile. Number three, intuitive navigation. You want to make sure that the whole hierarchy of the menu in the navigation bar is logical. When you go on the website, you expect the home page to be first, and then the service page, and then maybe portfolio, and then contact page. You never want to build your website, and on the nav bar, you want to put portfolio first, contact us, and then have the home page as the third button. It's just not logical, and no one actually thinks about this. You want to make the process of whatever traffic is coming to your website as easy as possible, and whatever they want to find on your website, they should be able to do so in less than 3 clicks. Make their whole process as easy as possible so then they have a good experience and they're more likely to come on your website, generating more money for your company as well. Number four, page load speed. That's so important, and that's the importance of having a good hosting provider. Every single second that your website loads, you have the chance of losing someone. I can't count how many times I searched up a website and then within 3 seconds, just because it didn't load, I just clicked off right away. I just didn't have the patience for it because most websites you go on load extremely fast, especially big companies. I invite you right now to search up Nike.com and see how fast it loads, no matter how heavy the website is and how many products they have on their website, because they understand that the page load speed is extremely important. And number five on this page, accessibility standard. So you want to make sure that the website is accessible to all users, whether it's on phone, tablet, desktop, like I said. You want to make sure that the contrast between the text and the images is good, especially if the text is above an image. For example, you don't want to have an image with a lot of lighting and then put white text on it because it'll be hard to see the text. Certain people, maybe you have good eyes, but certain people don't have good eyes and they won't be able to read the text on it. That person might be a client, and since he's not able to read the text, he won't know what steps to take in order to contact you or whatever goal you have with your website. Alrighty, so technical and performance aspect. So number one, security measures like installing an SSL certificate for secure website encryption. I'm gonna show you what an SSL certificate is if you don't know what it is. So if we go on Google here and write no SSL certificate and we go into images, you know when you go on a website and you see this right here, it won't even allow you to go on the website. So if you don't have an SSL certificate or the hosting platform you use doesn't have free SSL certificates that they implement into your website, that is horrible because in order to even go on the website, the person needs to go on a website that says your connection is not private and that the website might want to steal information from you. And then they have to click on advanced, and then that allows them to actually go on your website. And then there's this little icon on the URL right next to the URL that says, be careful, your connection is not secure, and this website might be wanting to steal your information. So please have an SSL certificate, or you will have absolutely zero people going on your website. Crucial. After that, we have the contact options. On the websites that I make for my clients, I always have the options to number one, call or fill out a contact form so then we can get back to them. Always include an email address if they want to reach out by email, a phone number, and also put the business hours on the website just so they know that if they call and they don't get an answer, they can always fill out a contact form and you will get back to them within business hours. Number three, we have website performance. So optimizing loading speed through image compression, browser caching, and all that sort of stuff. This is a little technical, so I can't really explain this in the video, but the hosting platform is also affects this. But you can also speed up your website by, for example, image compression. If you want me to make a separate video on this, let me know. I can do it, but I can't go into too much detail about this in this video. After that, we have backup and maintenance. If you have never backed up your website and you never ran into a problem, you don't know how important this is. I want to tell you guys a story about when I started my web design business. I was still using Cloudways as a host, which is very secure, and they also have malware protection, but I didn't turn it on for that specific client just because I thought, like, why would I need it? And my client's website actually got hacked. But thankfully, Cloudways automatically backs up your website every 24 hours, so I could just go in there and then pick a backup from a couple days ago and just reset the website to its original state. But it was horrible. I got so confused. I didn't know what to do for a couple days. I thought my client was not satisfied, and it was just such a headache. After that, we have the hosting infrastructure. I've been talking about this the whole video, but choosing a reliable hosting platform with sufficient bandwidth, storage, and processing power. So obviously that's important because if your hosting platform doesn't have enough storage, you won't be able to put everything you want on your website. So, all right, next step. Alrighty, so the additional features that are gonna help you build trust and improve the overall user experience. So, having testimonials, the more information you put about the customer, the better it is. So, if you can put a picture of him, if you can put his real name, real pictures of the job, what I like to do is having a before and after slider thing of a picture on the same angle. So, basically, just having a slider that compares before and after. So good, increases conversion rates like crazy. After that, we have service pages. So, creating dedicated pages for each service that will also improve SEO. So, if you do renovation in general and you do kitchen renovation and basement renovation, for example, having dedicated page instead of a one pager that explains both services, these two pages will also rank in the Google ranking. So then you can have more visitors on your website, obviously generating more revenue for your company once again. Social media integration. So, maybe having some of your Instagram posts or just your Instagram profile so people can follow you to increase the visibility on every single social media platform. This is not extremely important, but I like to have it just because it can grow the business overall. throughout every platform. Another thing that I don't always implement, but that's also great to have, is live chat support. So having a little chat box in the bottom right corner, that's just an AI that answers question, that will also qualify leads a little better because people that are going to call you don't have questions necessarily, and they just want to buy your service most of the time because if they did have questions, they could have just talked to the bot in the bottom right corner. So that also increases the chance of whoever is calling you is more qualified. Alrighty, so the next thing you want to ask your web designer is to test and then launch the website. Before you launch it, you want to make sure you test the browser compatibility. So you want to test it across every platform. So Chrome, Firefox, Safari, Internet Explorer, every single platform, you want to make sure it's mobile responsive on every single platform, as well as the performance is very good. And the reason for that is because obviously people are going to come on different platforms, and you want to make sure that you convert the higher number of leads as possible. After that, you want to test the form functionality. So you don't want to finish the whole website, make it high converting, have the service pages, have all the testimonials, the before and after pictures. The website is the most high converting it can be. And then someone fills out the form and it doesn't even work. You don't get their information to your email, and they can even submit the form because it says error on top. So you want to make sure that you test all of the features of the website just to make sure that the leads can actually convert and you can actually start generating revenue for your company. Last thing, post-launch support. That's extremely important because some web designers will build your website and then they will ghost you. They're not going to offer any maintenance, any technical support. What if 2 months from now, your website just stops working? Who's going to help you? One thing that I highly recommend is build your website on a very known platform like WordPress, Webflow, Framer, Wix. So then, if you run into a problem and something happens to your web designer, like they stop doing web design and they don't offer their services anymore, you can always go to someone else on Fiverr, or you can always learn it yourself through YouTube because those platforms are so well known that you can find any tutorial about the platform very easily in an instant. Alrighty, so now we just have an overview of everything we went through. The first thing, planning and preparation. So the initial strategy development, goal setting, the resource allocation for successful website implementation. After that, we have the design and the user experience. So making intuitive navigation that respects the hierarchy, making the website look good and logical. After that, technical implementation. So having a strong host and make sure that the performance of the website is phenomenal across all platforms. After that, feature enhancement. So having testimonials, dedicated service pages, social media, just so your clients can find you everywhere, as well as get all the information they need on your website. After that, testing and launching your website, make sure that the form works. Make sure that it works on every single platform, Chrome, Safari, whatever it is, Internet Explorer, Opera, whatever. And then after that, make sure that your web designer offers maintenance services or have someone else or learn yourself so that you can keep on updating your website if you were to have promotions or any of that sort of stuff for your service business. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope it was useful to you. If it was, make sure you like and subscribe, as well as follow my Instagram right here. I would love that. And if you have a service business yourself, or you're a web designer that needs more help in getting more clients or providing better service for your clients, you can book a call in the description on my Calendly link. We can hop in the call. I can see what I can do for you and help you. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.